So you've recorded a split stereo signal going straight into your camera. Now it's time to learn how to process each individual channel and make sure that when you export your video, that they are merged together so that your video sounds normal. I'm gonna teach you how to do this in DaVinci Resolve and Final Cut X, so let's learn how to do it. So with DaVinci Resolve pulled up, I have a sample clip here. Let me go ahead and play it for you. In this example, I'm using the Rode Wireless Go 2. One transmitter is clipped onto me, so you can... Okay, so you can hear how the music is coming out of the left side and my voice is coming out of the right side. So the first step we need to do is be able to split this stereo audio clip so we can work on each individual side. The first thing we need to do in DaVinci is when you click on the clip, notice how it highlights everything. We need to make sure this is not the case. So one way to do it is going over here and we click the unlink selection. From there, we'll be able to click on either the audio track or the video track individually. If you don't want to do it that way, what you can do is click on the clip, right click for the secondary option menu, and go to link clips, click that, and now they are unlinked. Either way works. So with the audio track highlighted, we're going to hold down option, or in Windows case, I think it's alt. We're gonna click on the clip and we're gonna drag it down and that's gonna duplicate it for us. From here, we need to now tell track number one to be either my voice or the music. And we do that by right clicking on this again. And we're gonna go down to clip attributes. It's gonna bring up another menu here. We wanna make sure we're in the audio tab and we know it's a stereo signal and we can see the channels. So what we wanna do is make sure that both are gonna say the same thing. So channel one going to the left, channel one going to the right. Once we click that, this now becomes our music track. So we're gonna do the same thing to the second clip over here. Go into clip attributes. This time we're gonna make sure that both of them say channel two going into the right and the left. And now you can see that the waveforms are different. This is my voice and this is the music playing. From here, you can start editing and doing whatever you want, whether it's increasing the volume of my voice and decreasing the volume of the music or vice versa. Or if you wanna EQ the music, EQ your voice, use your compressions and limiters, you can do that. Or something like this. I'm gonna do this real quick here. I'm gonna go ahead and make sure that's kind of leveled. I don't want the music to play right away, so I'm gonna make sure the music plays maybe somewhere around over here. And I also want it to slowly fade in. So now this is what this sounds like. Using the Rode Wireless Go 2, one transmitter is clipped onto me, so you can hear my voice on one side of the track. Okay, so now you can hear the music coming out from both sides. You can also hear my voice coming out from both sides. It cuts, it fades in. We're pretty much done with the clip. So what you want to do at the very end here, just to keep things organized, go ahead and highlight all three clips and we're going to link them all together. That way, when you're doing the editing, say for an interview, nothing is going to drift out of place. And that pretty much covers it for DaVinci. So now let's go over to Final Cut X. Okay, so now in Final Cut X, it's a little bit easier in my opinion, definitely not as many steps. So with the clip highlighted, we're gonna go over to our top right inspector over here, and we're gonna click on this little speaker icon. And what that's gonna do is it's gonna bring up something called audio configuration. We're gonna go over to stereo, and we wanna select dual mono. And you'll notice that it split the tracks here, and this is our music track, and this is our dialogue track. But we don't see it here necessarily, so how do we work with it? With the clip highlighted, we're gonna right click to bring up the secondary menu, and we're gonna go to expand audio components. Once you do that, we now see the music track up here and our dialogue track split. So same thing, if I wanted to do a very quick grade, not quick grade, but let's say I wanna raise my voice a bit, and we want the music not to be terribly loud. And I also don't want the music to start right where it is. I want it to start later. And then same thing, I want it to do a fade in.
Using the Rode Wireless Go 2, one transmitter is clipped onto me, so you can hear my voice on one side of the track, and then the other one's...
After you're happy with everything, go ahead and right-click, and we're going to go to Collapse Audio Components. And there we go. That's how you do it in Final Cut X. Understanding how to record and work with split stereo files from your camera is extremely powerful, especially if you are recording two people at the same time during an interview. But you don't have to use expensive dual-channel wireless systems to get split stereo. In fact, there's actually a very cheap way, and I'm going to tell you about it in this video.